Yes, class. What is visible to you in this slide? Larib, read these words that are visible to you. Larib, yes, I want you to read this slide. What is visible to you? UNITY. What is it, Larib?
Unity.
What is it, Mujtaba? FAITH.
Faith.
And what is it, Muhammad Sufyan? This one, the last one. Started with D. Yes.
Discipline.
Discipline. So what thing comes in your mind first? Yes. Unity, faith and discipline. What is coming in your mind after seeing these three words? Yes, any idea? Yes, Mujtaba, Larib, Sufyan, share beta. Unity, faith and discipline are actually the motto. Yes? Motto. Do you know motto? Motto of whom? Liaquat Ali Khan, Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah.
Qaid Azam.
Speak it loudly.
Qaid Azam
Muhammad Ali Jinnah. Yes, you are right. This is the motto of Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah: unity, faith, and discipline. Now, moving to the next slide. So, our topic is Pakistan Zindabad. Let's do the reading first. Yes. Mujtaba, read the first slide that is visible to you in front of you. If you have the book, it's good. Yes, read the first paragraph.
Pakistan Zindabad. Karachi, August 7th, 1757.
Yes, read it. If you have the book, read it.
Karachi, August 7th, 1957, a shining silver aircraft circled over the airport at Maripur and came smoothly into land, watched by a vast, excited crowd. First to step out of the airplane was a tall and very dignified elderly man, wearing a pure white salwar. As soon as he appeared, the whole crowd roared with one voice, "Pakistan Zindabad, Pakistan Zindabad," and every man pushed forward to welcome him. Get as close to him as possible to see him clearly. For here was the great leader, the Qaid-e-Azam. The originator, the first governor general of their new country. Here, home with them at last, was the leader who had won Pakistan for them, Muhammad Ali Jinnah.
Very good. Yes, Sufyan, read the second one.
As he drove through the great sea of people that stretched from the airport to the city, through all the cheers and tears of joy and the never-ceasing cries of Pakistan Zindabad, the Qaid-e-Azam gave no sign of his feeling. He rarely did so. If he felt pride or joy in what he did then, he did not let anybody see it. Through all the excitement of those first days in the life of the young nation, the man who had made it possible remained calm, serious and even severe. Perhaps he was thinking of the thousands who were being attacked and killed on the road and the railways as they tried to reach their new homeland. There was much in those days of violence to certain Jinnah, who was a man of a very strong feeling also, so he so rarely showed them. Yet, who were close to him on independence sometimes. So for a few moments, a happier man once he went to a balcony of the government house, where he could see without being seen, and as he looked down on the crowd, still cheering in the streets outside, he smiled, in that smile could be seen, the warm-hearted man behind in the stand by the album.
Very good. Now, you two have to underline the difficult words after reading. Underline the difficult words that you think that difficult and you need an explanation for these. Sufyan and Mushtaba, have you done?
Yes, that's correct.
Achha. Now look at the screen. Okay, now. Now Mushtaba, Sufyan, look at the screen. Yes, good that you are doing. Dignified. The word that I identified is dignified, never ceasing, stun, road, determination, spiritually. Is these are the words that you identified? Are these words are the same? Are these words are the same one? Yes?
They're not identify any words.
Okay, identified it later on. Okay, now copy down the difficult words that I am displaying in my screen. First one is dignified. Write it down the meaning of that one in your registers. Mohammad Sufyan Mushtaba. Dignified. Dignified means noble. Never ceasing. Yes. Sufyan, read the slide.
Miss your words. Dignified meaning noble. Never ceasing, constant. Stern, serious, roar, screamed, determination, willpower. Determination, willpower.
Willpower. Yes. Spiritually?
Spiritually, in a way that relates to deep feeling and belief.
Very good. Achha, okay. Now understand the meaning of these one. And I will be going to sharing this presentation with you on WhatsApp. No, okay. First one, dignified. Dignified means noble. Okay. Never ceasing, constant, stun, serious, road, scream, determination, willpower, spiritually in a way that relates to deep feelings and beliefs. Yes, you are right. Now next slide. As you have read the first and second paragraph, Sufyan and Mushtaba, students now pay attention. Look at the slide now. Look at the slide today. Okay? I will be sharing this presentation with you on my on your WhatsApp group. Okay, don't worry about that. Now pay attention to the slide that is displaying in front of you. That one is arrival of Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah at Maripur Airport, Karachi on 7th August 1947 in shining silver aircraft. Here the author starts his lesson by quoting the arrival of Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah at Maripur Airport, Karachi. Maripur Airport was the first airport of Karachi used for domestic flights. Okay. So here the author describing the this point in his first paragraph. Qaid Azam was wearing white pure Sherwani. Here look at the picture. This is the silver shining aircraft fleet. Yes. Of Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah along with his officials. So here, what are you perceiving from this picture? What are you wearing? What are you wearing? Yes. What is visible to you? Yes, Sufyan. Qaid Azam along with his
followers.
Yes, followers. Along with his followers. Along with his. Who is she? Who is she?
Fatma Jinnah.
Fatma Jinnah. Very good. So reply in a confident way. Fatma Jinnah. Yes, you are right. Qaid Azam along with his sister Fatma Jinnah coming out from the aircraft along with his officials and followers. Number of officials are standing in front of him to welcome him on Maripur Airport, Karachi. On 7th of August 1947 or 40?
1947.
1947. Reply it in a confident way, boys. don't be shy. Okay, next, coming to the next slide, Bide, here it is. Bide, in second paragraph, Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah arrived after on his arrival, Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah, as he drove through the great sea of people stretching from airport to city, cheering with joy and never ceasing cries of Pakistan Zindabad. But Qaid-e-Azam remained to be calm and serious because he was thinking of thousands of people who were being killed and attacked on the roads and railways as they tried to reach their new homeland. In the second paragraph, the author is describing the incident that took place after the creation of Pakistan when the British Empire announced the separation that now Pakistan is a separate state. So what did happen, Bide? Here the author again recalling the horrors of India-Pakistan partition. The horrors of India-Pakistan partition, which was reported by the survivors. Massacre began after the British announced partition. Neighbors slaughtered neighbors. Childhood friends became sworn enemies. Bungalows and mansions were burned and looted. Women were raped. Children were killed in front of their siblings. Trains carrying refugees between the two new nations arrived full of cops. These were called blood trains. Are you getting my point, Mushtaba Sufyan?
Yes.
Yes. Das, have you heard from the incident from your grandfather or grandparents that they reported how Pakistan came into being? Have you heard them? Have you heard it from your grandparents or no?
No.
You have no idea about how Pakistan came into being?
As in, we haven't heard it from our grandparents. Itna to pata.
Okay, so but any documentary that you have gone through, you want to share over here?
Any documentary? Someone was going from the center of India, but I do not remember the area. I saw it quite a while back.
Very good.
And they were moving through. It was a very hard journey, as they were showing. Like, they had scarce amount of water, food, and they had to hide away from the Indian army, etc., etc.
Good. Yes. So people were facing a crisis at that time when Pakistan came into being. Yes or no? Are you agree with this thing?
Yes.
Yes, so people, as they are the followers and they want to be in a new state, they sacrificed their life, they left their homes, their things, their everything. And now, what happened to them, Bide? As they try to reach to their newly born state, that is Pakistan, here the picture is displaying in front of you. I'm displaying the picture in front of you. Here the people are stating yes or no? Yes, Sufyan?
Yes.
On the roof of the train, under the yes. And somebody are outside the train and they are trying to go inside it. Number of people were there and they are trying to reach their home, Pakistan, as soon as possible. What happened during their journey? That Hindus and Sikhs attacked them. This is the thing, na? Are you agree with my point?
Yes.
Hindus and Sikhs attacked on their trains. They killed them. They and these trains are said to be as the blood trains. Blood train is the terminology used by the author in this lesson, that these trains are said to be as the blood trains because the survivors reported afterwards. Okay, now coming to the next slide video, here it is in a more visible. This thing is more visible, that people were sitting on the roof of the train trying to go to their newly formed state, Pakistan, but they have no idea they were killed afterwards and they were slaughtered afterwards. But they, as they are energetic, they were energetic, they have some passion that no, we will go and reach to Pakistan. So you know, the passion tha ke they want to go. They want to go Pakistan. They want to reach Pakistan as soon as possible. But they have no idea that during their journey, they face the circumstances, they face the consequences, and they will be slaughtered by the Hindus or Sikh. So here is the next slide visible to you. Yes, Mushtaba or Sufyan, yes, yes. Can you explain me, bete, what is visible to you? People, in the previous slide, people were on train. Now in this slide, what is visible? What are you perceiving from this slide?
People are just walking and moving through carts. They're just somehow trying to get to the
other. Yes, people are moving and in carts, and they are trying to reach their homeland as soon as possible. This is the thing. Yes, very good. People were carrying things. People were carrying their babies on their backs. So how they are? This shows their passion. Yes or no?
Yes.
Very good. So moving after reaching to Pakistan, beta Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah over here, beta, in the next in the same paragraph that you have read just right now, Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah. Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah addressed to presidential address to the Constituent Assembly of Pakistan in 11th August 1947. Here in the next paragraph, author is highlighting that Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah was addressed kar rahe the, to the Constituent Assembly of Pakistan on 11th of August 1947. Bete, after taking oath as the first Governor General of Pakistan, Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah addressed to the Constituent Assembly. And here, read the famous quotation of Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah. Yes, Sufyan, read it.
Dear teacher, yes.
Yes, read it, beta. Yes, read it loudly.
You are free to go to your temples. You are free to go to your mosques, to any other place of worship in this state of Pakistan. You may belong to any religion, caste, or creed. That has nothing to do with business of state presidential address to the Constituent Assembly of Pakistan, 11th
August 1947. In August 47. Pronounce it correctly. It's August, not August. Yes, Mushtaba, you want to explain? You are free to go to your temples and you are free to go to your mosque. What are you perceiving from this statement of Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah?
He's saying that you are free to practice your whatever religion you have as long as you do not irritate another person from a different religion, as long as you do not hurt them.
Very good. Very good. Do you think that this this thing or this main point is the main cause of creation of Pakistan?
Yes, the statement is the main cause of creation of Pakistan.
Yes. Very good. Definitely. This is the main cause of creation of Pakistan. That Muslims were not allowed to practice their religion, practice their teaching of Islam. Yes. So this is the thing about, and that's why here Qaid-e-Azam, after taking his oath as the first Governor General of Pakistan, he asked and he reported that you are free to go to your temples and you are free to go to your mosque, and there is nobody to ask you why you are doing this and that. You either you belong to any caste, you are free and to do what you want to do, and this shows the liberal person that Qaid-e-Azam was. It was a liberal person. So here, next, moving to the next slide. Yes, Peter, you have an idea about Pakistan resolution? Yes, anybody wants to reply? What is Pakistan resolution? When did it pass?
23rd March 1940.
Very good. 23rd of March 1940 it passed, and Pakistan resolution is the famous resolution. Any key point do you think that you remember about any key point of that resolution? Have you remembered any key point? No one? Okay. I'm displaying in front of you, beta, the Lahore resolution. Yes, yes. You want to share? Yes. Speak up.
Wasn't this where Liaquat Ali Khan presented the name for Pakistan and the idea that there would be a separate Muslim state?
Good, very good. Here, the resolution, Pakistan resolution, is said to be the Lahore resolution as well. Actually, this resolution was written and prepared by Muhammad Zafrullah Khan. Sufyan, do the reading of this slide
The Lahore Resolution was written and prepared by Muhammad Zafarullah Khan and was presented by A.K. Fazlul Haq, the Prime Minister of Bengal, was a formal political statement adopted by the All Indian Muslim League on the occasion of its three-day general session in Lahore, 22-24 March 1940.
Yes, good. Here, Lahore Resolution, Pakistan Resolution, it was written and prepared by Muhammad Zafarullah Khan. Muhammad Zafarullah Khan, here he is. Muhammad Zafarullah Khan, the picture is playing in front of you. He is Muhammad Zafarullah Khan. He he wrote and prepared Lahore Resolution. Okay, so he got that honor. And here, A.K. Fazlul Haq, Abul Qasim Fazlul Haq, his full name, Abul Qasim Fazlul Haq. He was popularly known as Sher-e-Bangla. He was popularly known as Sher-e-Bangla. He presented Pakistan Resolution. Okay, class, he is the one who presented Pakistan Resolution in front of the Muslims during three-day session at Iqbal Park, Lahore. So he is the one. His full name is Abul Qasim Fazlul Haq. He presented the resolution, the famous resolution, Pakistan Resolution, or it also said to be as Lahore Resolution. Now the key point of the resolution, as I have asked before, that Mushtaba, read this slide.
Muslims will not accept any plan which failed to give Muslims an independent state in those parts of India where there were more Muslims were Hindus, such as East Bengal and Northwest. The Indian newspaper called this the Pakistan Resolution.
Yes, very nice. You want to explain? Do you want to explain this, son?
They're trying to say that any place where there was Muslim majority, they are not willing to give this to India. They're saying that this should be a part of Pakistan. And then the Indian newspaper took the story and called it the Pakistan Resolution. They took the Lahore Resolution and called it the Pakistan Resolution.
Very good. Very good. Here in this resolution, Muslims asked that the majority of the Muslim states should be included in Pakistan in a newly formed state, that is East Bengal and Northwest. While this is the famous key point of Lahore Resolution, that Muslims will not accept any plan from India which failed to give Muslims as an independent state in those parts of India where there were more Muslims than Hindus, such as East Bengal and Northwest. These were the areas actually having high percentage and high ratio of Muslims. So that's why this is the main key point of Lahore Resolution, that they think that these two parts must be included in the newly formed state and afterwards it become Pakistan, because they include in Pakistan. And the Indian newspaper, famous Indian newspaper, called it as a Pakistan Resolution. They called it as a Pakistan Resolution. Now, I think all the points are cleared now. Yes or no? Yes. Yes, Vashiri. Points are cleared?
Yes, ma'am.
Here the summary that what we have learned today. Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah arrival at Maripur Airport in Karachi on 7th August 1947. Let's note down the key point. Beta, these are the key points that we have just discussed in this presentation. Qaid-e-Azam Maripur Airport, do you have an idea that now it's set to be as? Got an idea that Maripur Airport is now set to be as a? Yes. PF base Masroor. Have you heard it?
No.
No? PF base Masroor. Wait, and now Maripur Airport is transformed into PF base Masroor. Okay, beta? PF base Masroor. So,
yes.
Okay, remember this thing. Now search on Wikipedia, you will get the whole thing about that Maripur Airport, where it is. It is in Karachi, but now it is famous for, now it, this airport is turned to be a PF base.
It's a base.
Yes, it's a base at Masroor. So it is said to be a PF base Masroor. Second point, yes, Sufyan, read the second and third point. Yes. Yes, Sufyan, read the second and third point. Oh, he's not here. Mushtaba, you can read.
Okay. Great sea of people gathered to welcome their leader at airport. Qaid Azam was repressed for thousands of people being killed during migration of Pakistan.
Good. As I have mentioned you, great sea of people were gathered to welcome him. Is their great leader at the airport where Qaid Azam was depressed. Why he was depressed? Because he was in a nostalgic mood, because he was thinking of those people, of those thousand people who sacrificed their life, who were being killed by Hindus and Sikhs during the migration of Pakistan. While the fourth point is that presidential address to the Constituent Assembly of Pakistan on 11th of August 1947, here Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah, after taking it his oath as a Governor General of Pakistan, he addressed to the assembly and he highlighted the famous thing that you are free to go your temples and
mosques.
Very good. So here is the one. Now the last but not the least, let's keep the slide further. Pakistan resolution was passed on 23rd of March 1947 in Minto Park, Lahore. Class, have you any idea about Mushtaba? Now this park is said to be as?
Unfortunately, I do not.
Pan Park? Lahore Park?
Lahore Park?
Lahore Park?
Hey, mujhe nahi pata. Main aapse.
No idea about that. Achha, okay, now it's a trigger. No. It's a trigger for you, Mushtaba, that you go on net and then search. Okay? Now the Minto Park is said. What? Okay, this is the trigger. Okay, next, coming to the next slide. This is the critical phase now. Let's see. Okay, Sufyan wants to join or why he did? Achha, okay. Now. Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah arrived at Dash. Where did he arrive?
Manipur Airport.
At Manipur Airport. Qaid Azam was wearing Dash.
A white Sherwani,
very good. Qaid address to the Constituent Assembly on Dash.
August.
Is it 7th or is it 11th or is it 12th of August?
I'd say 7th.
Okay. It's 11th of August. 11th of August. 7th of August, he arrived in Karachi Airport, Maripur Airport. Well, 11th of August, after taking oath, he took his oath as the Governor General of Pakistan on 11th August 1947. Okay?
Yes.
Daesh presented Pakistan resolution.
Zafrullah Khan.
Very good. Zafrullah Khan. Fazlul Haq. Abul Qasim Fazlul Haq. I have shown you the pic as well, Mustafa.
Yes, I know.
Yes.
I didn't learn it.
He is known as the Sher-e-Bangla. Abul Qasim Fazlul Haq was the one who presented the famous Pakistan resolution in front of Muslims attending All India Muslim League 3-day session. Yes, now fifth one, park where Pakistan resolution was passed, known as Daesh.
Minto Park, Lahore.
Park, Lahore, very good. You are free to go to Daesh or Dash?
Temples or mosques.
Temples or mosques, yes. Now this is the home assignment, class. Okay. I will inshallah ta'ala place this home assignment on your WhatsApp group as well. State briefly what the Pakistan resolution decided. Okay. So this is your first assignment. This is your first assignment and it's it carries 10 marks. It carries 10 marks. So you have to do the research. Go through number of articles from the net or from your history books. Collect the articles, collect the key points from them, and then write just six lines on Pakistan resolution that you have to briefly state Pakistan resolution. Just six lines are required. So this is your first assignment. I think you have noted down. Have you copied?
Yes.
Okay, good. So this is the one board summary again. Alhamdulillah, we have done with the lecture. Thanks a lot.